Devin was one of the most driven individuals for personal health of anyone I had ever met. As a former Mr. Kentucky bodybuilder, you know, he took health to a level most individuals never even dream about.
Went every morning at 4:30 to the gym, and that morning, like all other mornings, he gets up, he gets ready, and then he kisses me bye, and as soon as he kisses me bye, then I get up and start getting ready for the day. And then I wasn't even up yet, and I hear a car, and I heard the car drive really fast through my driveway, and then I hear someone beating on the door. I always knew where he stood. I mean, we had repeated conversations about even having a trach put in. Never wanted to have a trach put in. Never wanted to be in a wheelchair. Didn't want to live if he'd be in a wheelchair. He wanted to go quick. My grandfather had a heart attack shortly after my grandmother got ill, and he died right then and there, and he always said, "That's the way I want to go, quick." And I was really torn, because I knew his wishes. I knew what his wishes were. Parts of his family, they were very opposed to me following the living will or following his wishes.
When you pick your insurance policy, you don't look at the type of benefits. You know, you're looking at, what does it cover drugs? What is my copay? Those are the things you look at. You don't look down through there and say, what if this happens? Because he's young guy, he's not going to look and say, what if I have a stroke?
And I know that as soon as you get your patient in the door, the first thing you're looking at is their insurance approval. Nothing is individualized, it seems like, from an insurance standpoint.
I actually pushed Devin to walk a little bit sooner than I really wanted to because of insurance. Because we continued to make progress up until the day he left. So when he left, we were still making progress, and that's why I wanted to keep him.
Since he's been home, He's slipped back.
That was the most frustrating part to me is knowing that we couldn't stay at Fraser. He was doing so well, and nobody deserved to get to stay there more. He worked harder, they said, than any patient they had ever had. He logged more therapy hours than any patient they had ever had and was progressing. So why could we not stay there? We had insurance. Why could we not stay? Makes no sense to me.
Here comes now. Here is our guy that we're doing this benefit for, Devin Dearth. He is going to be leaving April the 30th on a journey. And it's sad to say that, ladies and gentlemen, that we have to go to another country to get a therapy because it's too expensive in our own United States.
Hello, everybody. This is Ruth Leike. She's in Tianjin, China. And Ruth, we're here at the Second Baptist Church in Greenville, Kentucky.
Devin's going to be there for about 3 months of treatment. And the day runs, you get up about 7:30 and get ready and have breakfast. And then you exercise. You have the first hour of exercise, followed by a series of acupuncture. You have your morning treatments, which may be herbal soaks, tuna, or cupping in the morning.
Right when Ruth got there, she had lunch, or she went there, she got settled, she went to lunch, and then she came back 15 minutes, and then needles all in her right side, and then right after they took the needles out, she could already feel feeling back in her pinky.
A lot of people in the States do traditional Chinese medicine.
I was very reluctant at first. In fact, I was one of the most reluctant ones in the whole family.
I think it's great.
The Eastern medicine side of things, you know, that's, I don't know, I'd say it's worth a shot.
Still very excited about it. I think it's a great thing, and now we just gotta get all the stuff done, the paperwork and the plane ticket.
Uncle Doug promised me if they had a zoo where you could hold a baby panda, he'd take me.
And it's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
I